Mexicano, I'm working like a Mexicano. New persona, I'm moving on from Ferragamo. Get the llama, I party with the real Madonna. Beat the odds, do numbers, and remain humble. Drop top punches, I'm so used to this. Bugging at the pound, I'm so used to this. I know where I'm from, but I got used to this.
When you think about entering, or when you consider entering into a lease purchase, the question you need to ask yourself is, am I buying a truck or am I buying a job? A lot of people enter into a lease purchase without considering the ramifications of doing so. A lot of them, they do it to basically get away from what they think they're doing is getting away from the reins of management. They mistakenly think they have this power, do a little bit of work, you know, go on vacation, and then come back and make this big, gigantic settlement at the end of the week. And sad to say, you know, there's so many failures at lease purchase because of this one prevailing attitude is, you know, a lot of people mistakenly think that they bought a job. Buying a job and buying a truck, they're two frame of minds. Yeah, they're two different frame of mind. The first, you got the buying a truck in the form of a job. Some of the things that go with, some of the thinking that go with it is, you know, oh, when you get this truck, you can turn down loads because, I mean, in your mind, they don't pay enough. What else? Whew. Boy, it's a whole lot of things. You pretty much, you're getting in your own way. I mean, you do so many things that just basically destroy your ability to prosper at truck ownership. And eventually, over time, you do enough, or you do enough of these practices, and then finally, you know, you're gonna, you know, like you'll mess up at, or you'll mess one lease purchase up at one company, then you'll run to another company thinking that, hey, you can do it better, or you can do it better than the last time, and you still have the same practice. You never, you know, you never change your attitude. You go there with the same attitude, and eventually you'll do it so many times it turns into a vicious cycle. And then finally, hey, you'll just basically quit the industry altogether. When, hey, you know, if you just adjusted your attitude just a little bit, you could come out winning at lease purchase. On the flip side, when you buy a truck, I mean, you go into the agreement knowing full well what you have to do in order to make the lease purchase prosperous. There's a lot of sacrifice that goes into buying a truck. Some of the things include, you know, you have to get out there and start driving when you really don't want to. There are maybe times you'll go without even getting a settlement. I mean, you just can't worry about it. You know, you can't worry about not getting a settlement for the next week. Because, hey, look, like I said, you're buying a truck. That's what getting into a business entails. Some weeks you're going to go without any revenue coming in. But you have to be mature about what you're doing. And over time, you know, you will be successful at a lease purchase. You know, if you just keep that attitude in mind, you know. I'm not going to say positive because it's hard to stay positive when there's no money coming in. But you have to be an adult about it. And just know that, you know, hey, this week is bad. Next week is going to be better. Me, myself, whenever I do lease purchases, I never look at my settlements week to week. I gauge everything from 1 month to the next because, like I said, some weeks you're not gonna make that much. So at the end of the month, I tally everything up and get a running average of what I'm supposed to get paid, what all my bills are going to be, what my percentages are going to be, and then I pay myself accordingly. And I also do my taxes accordingly, because that's the one thing that gets you into deep trouble is not doing your taxes, you know, not turning in your taxes on time. I say a quick little story. When I did a lease purchase years ago, I was driving tankers, and it was a load that nobody wanted to touch. This load was running liquid from Torrance, California, up to the Bay Area, and then you go up to Ukiah, pick up some more liquid, run it back down straight to Mexico. So I talked with the guy. Nobody wanted to touch the run. It really didn't pay that well, according to what everybody, according to what everybody told me. So what I did was I crunched the numbers and looked at it very carefully, did a trip plan, put everything together. It was a three-leg run, okay? On two of the legs, they did not pay that well, but there was one leg of it that paid fairly well. It was paying about $1.75, $1.90 a mile. So I put everything together and determined that two legs of that trip, the two less profitable legs of it, I would use that for fuel. So I talked with the terminal manager and got him to give me an extra trailer to keep it staged down in Los Angeles, while I took the other trailer up, did my delivery up in the Bay Area and further north. I kept that rotation going, and that run, it was dedicated, it turned into a dedicated route for me. And I became incredibly prosperous with that dedicated route for almost 4 years straight. I kept those trailers rotating, swapping them out. I would drop one in LA while they get washed out. I would take a load up and just keep that cycle going, and over and over and over again. And the only reason why I had to give it up was because somebody else found out about that dedicated route and they wanted in on it. The one thing about it was that these guys were in lease purchase to buy a job, so they wasn't ready to sacrifice like I was sacrificed. Doing the route that I did, it required a lot of running at night, and then it required waiting to get in across the border into Mexico. I don't know if you guys ever crossed into Mexico, but it would take me up to 8 hours just sitting in the truck waiting to cross the border. And these guys were not willing to do that. And eventually, it was a guy who had seniority over me. He got on the route, and within 2 or 3 months, he burned completely out on the route. He just couldn't handle it. Guys, that is one example of the difference of buying a truck and buying a job. When you get into a lease purchase, weigh it out, and be real with yourself and ask yourself, am I buying a truck or am I buying a job? This is Mike. I'll see you guys in the next video.